Ever thought about owning the fluffy and cute Chow Chow? Or maybe you might just be generally interested in it. No matter, this video is for you. Hey guys, welcome back to the Paw Pals Pet Channel, and in today's video, I'm going to tell you about 10 things about the Chow Chow. It's only natural for you want to know everything about a pet before owning it, right? So stick around and watch to the end. However, before we start, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you never miss any updates. Now let's get into it. 10. Animal species. The Chow Chow is a breed of pooch that is a lot more different than average species and breeds. The breed was found in China and is said to date back to the Han Dynasty, about 206 BC to 220 AD. The Chow Chow is believed to be one of the oldest breeds and genetically very close to the wolf. 9. History. After genetic testing and long speculation, experts have confirmed that the Chow Chow is one of the oldest breeds. It is said that the breed originated in Mongolia and North China. Then, it slowly started to move towards the south with nomadic tribes of Mongolia. The Chow Chow appears in the pottery and paintings from the Han Dynasty. It is believed that one of the Chinese emperors had 2,500 pairs of Chow Chows for hunting. In China, the breed has several names such as the Black Tongue Dog, Wolf Dog, Bear Dog, and Canton Dog. In the 18th century, when the British took some of these beautiful dogs in their cargo, they called them Chow Chow, and the name just stuck to it. The Chow Chow were imported on a regular basis in the 19th century. The first Chow Chow that made an appearance on an American show was named Takya. 8. Chow Chow as a pet. Chow Chows are very loving of their families. However, that love is kept only within the family. Chow Chow is a high-maintenance dog that needs a very dedicated and committed owner. It is a very picky eater and has a lot of grooming to do. Generally, Chow Chows are healthy, but like all other dogs, they too can develop some health issues. 7. Care. Chow Chows are such pets that are able to adapt to a variety of homes, from palaces to apartments. But it is important that they live indoors with people and not in the backyard. Chow Chows are not able to cope with the heat outside, so keep them inside when the weather is extremely hot. Chow Chows are not like other dogs that love wandering around, so you could leave it in your house and it will stay secure. However, we would recommend that you set up a fence just in case. 6. Attention. Most dogs love attention, but Chow Chows are quite different from them. Usually, Chow Chows are independent, calm, and mostly reserved. They don't require a lot of attention, affection, or regularly seek hugs and cuddles. What is interesting is that they don't like being fussed over and watched over all the time. Instead, they're always attentive, staying by the side of their owner. 5. Exercise. Like any dog, an adult Chow Chow needs daily exercise to stay happy and healthy. But not much. He'll be satisfied with a couple of 15-minute walks daily, or one long walk. 4. Family pet. Chow Chows are never aggressive, nor are they shy. They basically mind their own business and don't go around starting trouble. Chow Chows love playing with its people, but if a stranger approaches them without permission of their owner, it will challenge the stranger. If the permission is given, the stranger won't be of any interest to it, but it will be comfortable with the stranger touching it and playing with him. If the Chow Chow is raised with kids, it can do well with them, but as it is not rough and tumble kind of dog, it won't tolerate any form of abuse from the kids. So they do best in families with kids that know how to treat it right. Chow Chows should be socialized and trained well so that they can get along with all other pets. This can be achieved easily if they are introduced at a young age. Chow Chows do best with dogs of the opposite sex. The Chow Chow has deep-set eyes and a large head, accentuated by a mane of hair. It is quite an impressive-looking dog, and from its looks, it might look as if it's ill-tempered or mean, but it is far from it. 3. How to care. When it comes to grooming, you'll have to brush its coat at least 3 times a week in order to keep it in good condition and prevent the falling of loose hair around your house. Chow Chows are heavy seasonal shedders and their coat requires extra care at that time. One benefit is that their coat will have no doggy odor if brushed regularly. You will need a stainless steel greyhound comb with medium coarse teeth, a medium-sized slicker brush for the legs, and a medium pin brush for the longer body coat, along with a diluted spray bottle of coat conditioner. You will have to bathe your Chow Chow at least once a month. However, it can be more than once if it plays outside more frequently and gets dirty. Apart from that, you need to brush your Chow Chow's teeth at least a couple times a week to wash off the tartar buildup and bacteria. However, daily is better. Secondly, you will need to trim his nails as required, maybe once or twice a month. 2. Feeding. When it comes to feeding, it is recommended that you feed them 2 to 2¾ cups of high quality dog food daily. That will be divided into 2 meals. It's pretty obvious that how much your cute Chow Chow will eat depends on its size, age, build, metabolism, and activity level. Just like people, pets need different amounts of food. It's pretty clear that a Chow Chow that likes to lie down on a couch all day and a Chow Chow that frequently play jump around and play inside the house will require different amounts of food. The quality of the dog food that you are feeding your Chow Chow will also make a huge difference. The better the quality of food, the better your pet will be nourished. You can keep your Chow Chow in good shape by measuring the amount of dog food and feeding him twice a day rather than leaving it out. If you feel it's overweight, give it the eye test and the hands-on test. Observe your Chow Chow carefully. You should be able to see a waist. Then place your hands on its back, thumbs along the spine with fingers spread downwards. You should be able to feel its ribs but not see it. And if you can't feel its ribs, then your Chow Chow may be overweight. 1. Training. Chow Chows can be easily house trained, but it is recommended that you give them crate training too. Crates make house training a lot easier. It will keep your Chow Chow from chewing things when you're away. However, think of the crate as a tool and not as a jail, so don't keep your Chow Chow locked up inside for too long. Chow Chows are dogs that are capable of learning anything you teach them. Commands by the master are enough to set them straight. In order to train him without much trouble, you need to earn his respect in puppyhood. If you treat the Chow Chow right, then you will find an extremely loyal companion who will always treasure you. And that's all for today's video. Thanks for watching it. If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Tell us in the comments below what you think about this cute fur baby. Lastly, if you have not already subscribed to the Paw Pals Pet channel, make sure to subscribe to it and press that bell icon so you're notified each time we upload an interesting video. And while you're here, click to watch one of the 2 videos appearing on your screen right now. See you there, take care, and stay tuned.